part to of universe mode. We have this, then another match, and after that match, and after that match, we have another promo. I don't know about all of you, but today is a special day. In fact, it is so special, I want to celebrate alone. Matt Hardy, join me in the ring. Since you're my partner and my brother, it's only fair you be out here with me. You got me out here. Obviously, you've got a lot on your mind. Let's get it out. Come on, man. Say what you've got to say. From day one, I've been waiting for you to step up and actually prove you have what it takes. And you know what? I'm still waiting, but I can't wait anymore. We're done here. Oh, you think I'm terrible, really? That's funny. Coming from a guy like you, a guy who's too busy selling his looks instead of getting ready for his match, styling his look instead of getting ready for his matches. I don't care what you say or who you say it to. The only way you and I will stand in the same ring together is as opponents. And when that day comes, I'll show you just how great I am and how great and why I'm the better brother. Congratulations, you've got your So, another enemy around here. I almost feel sorry for you because now you're on your own. And one day, when you least expect it, I'll be there. And you're going to get what you deserve. Jeff Hardy just warned his brother, folks. Yeah, but he's on SmackDown. Guess he was traded. I guess he needed to come out here and get this off his chest. Our next match is with Bobby Roode versus Sami Zayn. Thank you. Bobby Roode's first match on Raw. And Bobby Roode wins his first match here on Raw. Boom, look at that cutter. Spinebuster. Look at a glorious DDT to put away Sami Zayn. Come on. Shoot, Gizmo. All right, I'm coming. Come right now. And not again. And again with a glorious DDT. Sorry about that, guys. I had some business I had to tend to. Ooh, who is Taz gonna call out? Who's Taz gonna call out? Shut up! What is Taz out here for? You all know why I'm out here. There's been a lot of talk in the WWE lately. More than normal. More than there should be because it's empty talk. Well, I'm a man of... I'm not going to stand on the sidelines while it crumbles. So this is what it comes to. I work slave bodies. Seems like a waste of both of our times, mine, because he's a weakling and beneath me. He's because no matter how I beat him. So Finn Balor, you want to talk about me in the back? Why don't you come out here and say it to my face? So I can choke you out. Finn Balor is the Intercontinental Champion here on Raw. He's ready. I was sitting back in the locker room thinking about what superstar I wanted to add to my win list when suddenly out of nowhere this intriguing noise began to fill my brain. Look, you can come out here and run your mouth all you want. All it does is expose you for the fraud that you are. There's only one man who reads history every time he steps into this ring, and you're looking at him. I'm not sure if you actually think you're intimidating anybody with this garbage. I've faced the best in this business, and I didn't beat in line, so I'm not about to break a sweat for you. Got it? Bad enough. Yeah, you've faced the best in the business, but you've never faced me, and you might think you know what you're up against, but trust me, you don't. Take the worst trouble you've ever had and triple it. Look, if you're looking to make a name for yourself and get a... I can help you, but if it's a fight you're looking for, we can do this anytime, anywhere. I hope for your sake that you weren't foolish enough to bring your family here tonight, because if they see what I have in store for you, they'll be the ones crying as they watch someone they love get beaten and battered. You seem to think that I got to leash on me. You're really mistaken, my friend. Be careful. And the next time you decide to go barking little doggy, make sure you know whose yard you're in. Damn. Balor told him. Balor told him. I guess double. Okay, so I didn't know there was two matches with Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins, so we're gonna stimulate it. Okay, well, Rhino and Slater won. Okay, now why is this promo? I see changing tide here in the WWE. It's probably not as small. I've been doing this thing my way since the day I got here. And my way, I'll admit, worked right for a time now. Though I'm looking back and realizing that every single accomplishment, every single win is what good is it being hated and feared if you're not respected? That's what I'm after, respect. Whether you want to give it, that's up to you. I'm taking my own destiny into my hands now. No more asking for special favors. No more complaining about being overlooked. I am going to take action and earn everything I desire. If you guys are willing to support me, we can change the WWE Universe together. We can rule the WWE Universe like superstars, and people who watch that superstar, let me work on that. Anyway, let's make the WWE great again. Well, Elias wants to make the WWE, he wants to make WWE great again for all the fans out there who are not Elias believers. So after this match, next time Universe Mall, John Cena calls out a mystery superstar. Then we have Zack Ryder versus Eddie Guerrero. Then Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler versus Cedric Alexander in the main event of Raw. We are going to commercial break. We'll be right back, folks, with this huge tables match between the Glamazon and the Boss. Ooh.
Guys, what do you think about Beth Phoenix? Hard to predict this early in the match, but what do you think she needs to do to win here?
You know, you don't get this much, but right now, I see someone who knows the value of hard work and dedication. One thing I can say about her is if she does get beat, it won't be because of a lack of preparation or effort.
Damn, so many. The worst anything.
Beth Phoenix is in some trouble here. We've certainly seen her withstand worse in the past, though. Sasha Banks needs to do to get back into this battle. At this point, it's fair to wonder how much more she has to give here tonight. And there's the reversal from Sasha Banks. Okay, now she's just showing up. This could be all she wrote. Another fisherman suplex. Now that's how you make a mistake. There's no way this match isn't over after that one. Looks like Beth Phoenix is taking the upper hand. Is not looking good here. She looks dangerously close to losing this match right here, guys.
Well, I think it's safe to say that she's going to lose this match if she doesn't figure out a way to get back in this thing immediately.
Great reversal by Beth Phoenix. Oh, man, we've got a problem here, guys.
No kidding. Who knows what will happen next?
Look at this.
show in history.
And Banks avoids the table, which that's a disaster.
Struggling big time here, guys. Of course she has goals. She's getting destroyed. She can't take any more of this. She might have it. And she might expect it. Situation is not looking good for Beth Phoenix. She may very well have reached the point of no return. Why is he bringing the action back into the ring? Watch out. Wow, what a slam. Don't let the beauty fool you. She has power. Oh, no, she's not getting up. That's a pinner. This match is over.
Oh, this could be it right here. Slam through the table. Banks is out. What a match. Thought it was over right here, but Beth missed it by an inch. John Cena call out. John Cena, call out. Let's hear him out. Kane, you want to have your moment? Then come out and come on out. He's calling out Kane. And here comes the big red machine. I'm sorry to interrupt, but I learned a long time ago that the only way I get attention around here is to just take it. It's nothing personal, but I've got something on my mind, and I need to deal with it right now. Why am I not surprised? Oh, that's right, because this is the sort of thing that happens all the time. You've never been able to get attention without stealing someone else's spotlight.